Hands that weave pages of history and patterns that accompany the murmurs of prayer by mystics in the heart of the night, shaping a group of people's identity in southwest Iran.
By traveling to Shushtar, you could definitely experience a travel through a time tunnel. And this is one of the places where it takes you deep into the heart of the history in this region. In ancient Persian, Shush means good, Shushtar means better. And this is the name of one of the oldest cities of Iran that dates back to the Parthian and the Sassanid era. Today, the city of Shushtar is known for a lot of things, including its ancient hydraulic structures and its exclusive urban architecture.
Shushtar has a collection of attractions from different eras of Iran's history. From the 1700-year-old handmade water mills to old bazaars and colorful handicrafts, Shushtar was the provincial capital of Khuzestan during the Qajar era, nearly two centuries ago. Qajar architecture is still widely seen both in mosques and houses of the city.
The house of Marashi is one of the clear examples of traditional Shushtari architecture during the Qajar era. During those days, architects used very simple materials such as bricks and cubes of limestone to create what is still known today as one of the most attractive buildings of the city.
Today, Marashi's house is used as the head office for restorations of Iran's cultural heritage organization in the city of Shushtar. But the glamour of this mansion is not only due to the beauty of its architecture, but also to its exceptional panoramic view of the Shushtar hydraulic structures. After all these years, Marashi's house is still the best place where you can lose yourself by watching over this magnificent piece of Sassanid architecture all day long.
I've only been here since yesterday, but already I've noticed sometimes you turn a corner and you go straight from busy city into history, basically, including the dams, obviously, but also small alleys and corners. It's quite interesting.
In old Shushtari architecture, it was not just the main building that offered beauty, class, or comfort. In fact, a great deal went on right under each building in the basement, a place where some have been able to use differently today.
During the past 30 years, Mr. Nejat Fathi's passion to revive the culture of his city, Shushtar, has prompted him to gather an interesting and at the same time weird-looking collection of items that were used by the people of Shushtar since 200 years ago. These pair of slippers are known as karkab. They're made from 100% natural wood. And they date back to a time when there was no plastic. People used to wear these on wet surfaces, such as in baths.
که هستیم شبستون خونه مرعشی هستش که اختصاصش دادیم به موزه مردم شناسی یه سری اشیاء و لوازم معرف زندگی گذشته مردم شوشتر یکی از پوشش‌های تزئینی خانم‌های شوشتر این طرح بوده که اصطلاحاً بهش میگفتیم دوم یا همون دامی که به اصطلاح برای ما ایجاد اسم این خانشه است خانشه یعنی سفره کوچک
I wonder how they used to carry the bride's dowry with this. It's so difficult to handle.
رروک وسیله ای که برای اطفال درست میشه. اطفالی که رو چارچ دست و پا را میرفتن میخواستن رو دو تا پا را برن این کمکشون میکرد که به این صورت
یواش یواش آمادگی پیدا کنن برای رود و پارا رفتن.
اسم ای مهلبه که برای دوشیدن شیر به این صورت استفاده میکردن. اینجا وسایل کتابت و صحافیه. اینجا که داریم میریم شوادون اسمشه. در عمق بیشتری قرار داره. دمای هوا تو شوادون معمولا حدود 20 درجه اختلاف دما با سطح زمین داره.
The Shavadun was the lowest part of the building, but sometimes families use it as a shelter in difficult times, such as in wars. What was interesting about the Shavadun was that it was connected to three other neighboring chambers through a tunnel known as Kure. And it was through this Kure that neighbors were able to stay connected while exchanging food and even weapons. Shushtar is like an old tree whose roots are still drinking from the streams of history, a city of ancient bridges, dams, mosques, and talented people. Amir Mehdi Kazemi for Iran.